Viens, petite fée, dans mon comex, je viens faire le but. Faire des whips, des whiz, des pow, chiba, pow, pow, whiz.
I am writing. That's a blessing. It's quite a moment. I didn't say okay. That's my pure infinite joy. Let's go writing. So there's a lot to do. Something is really cool is happening.
I'll drink a little bit of wine. Super good Chardonnay, white wine. Ooh, organic wine is very good. And so I can forget that I was so stupid and I was just focusing on what I don't like. For years and years, I was so stupid. And I was like, but you know how it works. And I was like, oh, I don't like that. I don't like that. And I said, oh, I know what I like and I can check on it and put my mind and heart on what I like and be grateful every day. It's a step of every day because they talk and talk and talk. I tell you something. Be grateful each time you buy strawberries, potatoes, tomatoes, whatever it is. Be grateful for you get cigarettes, bed, clothes, friends, phone, cellular, everything, the sun, the flowers. Thank you, oh God. So much great Almighty God, so you love us so much and you create us so perfect and we just got it. Now we just really, really understand that you love us so much that what we talk about, what we think about, what we feel about, you give it to us with no judgments. Thank you, guys. So since now, really, really, I got it. I found a book of my mom. So she was really awake. I was like, oh, I just can't believe I found that book. And really, it's hypnosis book. And I was like, oh, you got that book. And my mom, all the book I love is the book of my mom. And she was really looking for many information. She was awake. And I love her so much. She was so beautiful, and I feel her presence, her love. That's a blessing. So really, it's not saying information and things and things and things, because if you feel it, you got to feel yourself, and you think about the shirt you wish and the color of the shirt you want, and you feel yourself in that shirt and things like that, you know. By the way, that's such a blessing because my mom, she do the same I do. I mean, she take a book and with pencil to draw, you know. She put things. She underlined the stuff. She put. She mark. She write on the books and things. So I feel her energy everywhere. She was vibrating to what is written. That's a blessing. I really found a book today. I took like 10 minutes on it, and I was like, aha moment. I was like, oh, I got it. I got it. Yes, now I understand. Because the books say exactly whatever you feel, whatever you want, and whatever you focus on, don't ever put a contrary idea. Don't ever, ever second. Be strong. Put all your focus and don't move from that focus. You decide the stuff, send it to the universe, and the universe is gonna find a way to give it back to you. It's amazing. And I'm gonna tell you a key. Till that moment, you don't start to understand that the Creator loves you and love us so dearly, with no difference, nothing. But he know the people who come and come and come to him. He know the people who walk for others, who pray for others, who do efforts. We are not, nobody is better than another one. God loves us, all of us, with no judgment. It's pure. full of. It's like you fall, you swim in a fountain of infinite love. I know because I've been over there. You swim in an ocean of deep, deep love. If you, at the moment you focus on the stuff, God gave it to you. So watch out. Jesus say, be very careful on each thoughts as to got a reason to be there. Each of your thoughts has to got a reason to be sent to the universe. Don't ever forget that. Even if your faith is like beans, and I know your faith is a seed so small because you got all your stuff and things. Don't ever put your stuff on God. God loves you and He gave you a challenge. So now you're going to uplift that challenge and go over the challenge and say, okay, okay, I choose my parents. Okay, I choose my mission. So now I'm going to go all over that stuff and I'm going to be the best. And I'm going to grow myself from nothing. I'm going to build myself from nothing. That's just exactly what Jesus did. Even if it was written, he really built himself from nothing. He was some of them wanted to kill him, and he was talking. And, you know, you have to give a little chance to God. Give a little chance to God. That's a good, good, very good way to say it. I really, really, really wish, let's dare to be happy, let's dare to be happy. Really, let's dare to take away that stuff. We are so shy in front of God. We're shy. We are small, we don't know, we were lost, we forgot our mind. Let's throw our brain in the ocean. Throw your brain in the sea. That's so true, because we are thinking, and most of the time you get 60,000 thoughts a day, but 96.4% of them are negative. You can imagine what the mess. And I realized that's my stuff. I was like, I meet someone, I'm like, oh, this person loves me, hello, na na na. And then I met another person, a girl, and she, oh, she doesn't love me, and I feel disappointed, and go like, then they say, no, Caroline, whatever she think, who care? Be a light, bless her, be love, love her, send her good vibes, send her good vibes, shine in the name of the Lord, shine on. Be the best, shine on. She doesn't like you, she doesn't like her. That's the point, she doesn't like her. So she look what, anything she think, she imagine she doesn't like about you. She doesn't even know you. Who care? Don't take her mess, bless her. Love her unconditionally. Her, anybody, bless, bless, bless. Don't see the people looking their face and see da la 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 la. Look at their eyes. That's what I say. Look their eyes and bless them, because they are a particle. They are a small part of God. They are a small part of that energy. You see, all we study. This is an amazing energy. This is a huge energy. It's unbelievable. The more I focus, the more I study cells. It's an arm, like an army. You give an order and they say, okay, I'm going to give that to you. And you feel like that and say, okay, feel your shit. That's exactly what talking with God, the Donald Walsh, he was so fed up, so mad, so under the press. And all of a sudden God say, did you get enough? Is it enough for you? You want to keep on your shit? Did you get enough of your stuff? And then all of a sudden you go like, yes, sir. More than enough. So he said, come with me. Come with me. And angel, most of the time he said, come with us. I'm like, ew. And I hear, come with us. I'm like, How did I do that? And I know how do I do that. I mean, I don't care anything, my blah blah, my brain. I say, be kind, be cute, do your stuff, do your writing, have fun, do anything with fun. When you have to clean the house, don't complain. It's okay, you got a house, clean it. Okay, there is a lot of work. Be grateful, love it, be patient. When you froze it, it can take time. When you start from zero. You start your stuff, and then you focus on your things, and you work properly and things. It ain't gonna come in a second if you are not a master, when you are a great master. I tell you, by my experience, it comes a few hours, a minute after. When you are a beginner, it can take 2 years. Be patient, be confident. Throw your seat and say, it's gonna be like that because I choose it like that. Feel yourself on a boat. Feel the waves. Feel the color of the sea. Feel yourself happy. And it's gonna come to you because the universe is gonna find a way to come to you. Because if you feel yourself on a boat with friends, with the sun, with the sea, with nice clothes and things, it gonna come to you, I tell you. I've been experimented that. I saw myself on a dream and I was like, who is that? And I was so beautiful with long hair, blonde, very long, 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 with nice dress. And I was like, ooh, what a beautiful woman, who's that? And they say, it's you. And I was like, ooh. And yes, now I'm like that. My hair are long, I wear dresses and things. I'm like, phew. And people, they say, wow! I see a woman, she was working for fashion. So she's special. She see me last year, and then she see me a month ago. And she was like, oh, what happened to you? And I was like, what? And she said, oh, look at you. You're so gorgeous. Oh wow, and I was like, you kidding, what's going on with you? And she was like, ah, you are so beautiful. And I was like, oh, I always dreamed to be beautiful. When I was 20, I thought I was beautiful. Maybe I was, I don't know. But now I feel myself, I don't care if I am so skinny or a little bit round. I adore myself because God is within. And I start to adore myself. I say, I adore myself for the love of God. Because I adore God so much. I'm going to tell you, now I can tell you. I was under the star. I have to tell you what happened. Really listen carefully. I was doing a blessing to God. And every night I do that. Oh, wow. Lift up the faith. We have to get out of, if you look for something that doesn't make you feel good, take it away. If you watch a video that you don't feel comfortable with it, take it away. If you got a bad thought, take it away. If you feel bad about yourself, take it away. If you look at yourself in the mirror, la 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 la, look at yourself with love. It's okay, the way you look, the way you are, it's okay. And I start to do that, I say, I love myself, and I say, I am amazing. I am beautiful inside and outside. I am God creation, I am beautiful. And people are like, oh, you're so beautiful. They stop me in the street and say, oh, wow. You know? And I feel amazing, happy, and people will stop me in the street and say, oh, you are so beautiful. And I'm like, phew. But nothing's changed. I'm still the same. I'm not 20 anymore. But I'm still the same. I feel like I'm 18. You know? And people are like, ew. And I say, okay, so now if I can lift myself in an appearance of loving myself. We are all different looking. Who cares? Love yourself. Love yourself. Kiss yourself in the mirror. Be kind to you. and everything is gonna be okay. We're gonna work step by step, you know. We're gonna make it. We're gonna make it. See everybody around you doing a round, uniting, be happy, be hugging everybody. We all unite. We bless Gaia. We unite. We send love to the universe. See, your heart is like a treasure. Your heart is a blessing treasure, full of love. It's inside. It's a treasure with diamonds. See that in you. God loves you unconditionally. It's just in your idea what's going on. It's just because God's going to give you always what you think about. Always. He say, you think like that? You're going to get it. You think like that? You're going to get it. So you choose what you think. And God's going to give it to you. So there is a moment and you say, I don't want to be like that anymore. I want to be a winner. I want to be a winner. So there is a way, another way. So I'm going to play it. I'm going to play with the universe. I want to have fun with the universe. The more I win, the more other win around me. And that's the truth. And say, okay, so now, how is it exactly? And you always feel something. How did you act? And say, oh, you could have been better. Oh, I'm going to be better next time. It's okay. And God told me once, he said, don't go with no vanity. And go with no culpability and no vanity. Do your life. Go with no culpability and no vanity. And I'm thinking about that lately, and I was like, no guilt and no culpability. No vanity and no culpability. No vanity, no culpability. And it puts you right in the middle of where everything is. No vanity. No culpability. So beautiful. And when you say everything is connected, you have to really understand that you are connected to the tree, and the tree is sacred. And especially for me, it's easy. And I feel the roots of the tree, and I say, I love you. I really love you. I'm going to keep you. I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to keep you till you are here. Because you are sacred to me. When I see I got a squirrel in the garden, I say, oh, it's a blessing when I see that squirrel playing in the trees and things, the birds. I kiss it. I go on the ground. Often I go on the ground. I feel it now. I kiss the earth. I kiss Mother Earth. I send her love. Sometimes I say, help me. And she said, yes, I'm going to help you. So most of the time I say, I love you so much. I send you so much love. And I know she feel it. I was feeling like dancing on, I was uplifted, walking uplifted, like levitating, you know. Kiss the ground, kiss the trees, send them love, be crazy, lose your minds, open your hearts. Go connect with the universe. The universe is within. It's not sentence. We have to feel it. We have to lift our emotion with such a state of love that we fly with wings. That's the point. Flying with wings in our hearts. Be completely mad because he saw a butterfly. Me, I go like that. I see a butterfly. I'm like, hello, how are you so cute? Oh, watch out. Oh, you want this? Oh, I love you. I see a ladybird. I go like, oh, you see? I wanted to tell you something very important, much more important than you can imagine. There is like, how do you say that? It's like a rainbow. It's like something very subtle. It is a divine energy. For all those guys many of them, and more many of them, they only do one thing. They translate in an easier way. Actuality, exactly word for words, what the Lord says to us, all of us. At the beginning of the time, it was meant not to be understood by bad people. So he decided to use what he called parables, which are like kinds of metaphor, to talk to the good souls and the good hearts living on earth. Then for universe is moving up and trying to bring us all to an uplifting dimension. Universe decide to give some tools to its kids for their awake, all of them. So he allows some faithful people to get more knowledge and catch some keys for living happily. There is one principle which is called God. That is a huge energy of light, happiness, faith, health, harmony, pure love, pure joy, needs fulfilled, and sharing, compassionate energy. So in that state, everything become like synchronicity. But only in that state. So that's the first point. Second point, this is very important, is not trying too much, because when you try too much, is I don't know, it doesn't have to be by force, it has to be by faith. Everything has to be by faith. So don't force and don't try too much, otherwise you can like build a wall. So I wanted to share with you that you have to understand just one point, very important and so easy, that visualizing yourself. Look at yourself. I mean, take like a camera, lifting, visualizing you from above and see yourself. So in that way you can understand that you're getting humble, we're getting humble and we're getting more loving to ourselves and more compassionate to ourselves. So we, at that moment, when you see yourself from above, you can understand that there is a force, a law that watch over you, like shining your hair and your spirit and your heart. And then it becomes easy and easier. So when you look at yourself from above, it's like connecting with the eye of God and look at yourself with unconditional love and respect and kindness and understanding and so on. And it becomes easier to let go with any anger and stuff, to overs. Because spiritually talking, everyone got his own way. So I wanted to share that with you. It's very important, but because looking at too much videos, looking at too much stuff and stuff and stuff, maybe can be too much. But personally, I like very much Dr. Joseph Murphy because he's a priest. And because he always get back himself to God and put God in himself, and that's the way it is. Otherwise, and that's why it doesn't work. As simple as that, it doesn't work. And God is the intelligence of the universe, and he chooses. And if it seems to work for the bad people, Jesus Christ himself says, the first will be the last. But the last gonna be the first, which means that bad people gonna fall, and humble and kind people gonna lift. So it can take time that universe catch you and recognize your presence and identify you. And to be identified by the universe, it takes time. It takes a lot of work. I mean, you see, Louise Hay, she been coming back from so many things, and her childhood was so heavy, and all of a sudden she understood the most important thing of all. She understood the love of God for her. Whatever happened before, she really catches that energy, and it's like a wave. You're surfing on a wave, and the wave is the universe, and the wave is the unconditional pure love, like an ocean. So I'm going to give you an advice that really, really learn to say thank you to the Lord. Thank you, I don't know you yet, but thank you, I wish so much you come in my life, more present, more in my heart, more guiding me, and forgive me for my anger, or for my past error, or anything that you dislike, and guiding me with your beautiful light and love. For I'm like your kid, and I want to adopt you in my life. Thank you, Lord. It's really, I'm going to tell you something. Try it. Try to connect with the energy of love. Because God, like it is said, is a very, very powerful word. I mean, used with love intention in your heart. So, as you mentioned God, you start to vibrate and uplift in your soul and things. But as you mentioned God respectfully, you know, oh my God, and things. This doesn't mean anything. But, oh, dear Lord, I love you so much, really, really love you. It's exactly like I told you, I was under the stars, and I said, God, will you please accept to receive all my love? I adore you so much. And then, I see a star running just above my head for me. You see? So that's the beginning of the miracles. There is a connection to do in your hearts with the Creator, which made you as you are. I mean, totally perfect and adorable. So at the moment you understand that, everything will flow now, because you've been studying and studying and searching, and God wants you to be happy, and all that you want is God's will for you. So when you understand all that you wish is God's dream for you, you're going to fall in love with God, and you're going to fall asleep awake in an amazing reality. But it is step by step. It's not that freeing yourself 6 months away or 1 year away. It's projecting yourself right here, right now, as you dream of it. So surround yourself with light and love and grateful. And then it's going to be really, really easier. Don't push it. Accept it. That's the best gift I can give you with all my love. I just been published Les Mémoires d'un âne à son coq with the funny draw. I'm gonna see how it looks because it's funny for me, so it's more easier. I want to open the door for more readers. I took away like six poems. I clarified some stuff, and well, it's gonna be. It's a funny, funny cover, very, very funny. So I really do it in the goal to give a bigger chance to poetry to attract more people. So let it roll, let it roll. God bless you. I love you a lot. And I hope you're going well and everything is okay out there. I mean, there is one principle, which is the key of everything. Listen carefully to the most important keys is to be motivated by love. I mean pure love gonna get anyone to ecstasy, you know, ecstasy is to be pure like Jesus Christ, so it asks a lot of work, inside work, because for example, Wayne Dyer, he always say, my kids love cash. But he never used the word money because money is a darkness energy. For I'm going to give you proof that in Emoto works, that word produced like a shit. But the word love produced like diamonds. And abundance and prosperity are good words. Positivity, kindness, sharing, produce light. So light goes to light, and the light go bigger and bigger. Because if you put a match, as you remember, under the sun, you ain't gonna see the match. You're gonna see only the light of the sun. But if you put a little shadow. It's gonna produce darkness, like a little darkness. So I observe by myself that, for example, fear or doubts, which doubt mean in Hebrew language, it means devil. It means Satan. I was voiceless when a friend of mine who studied a lot told me that. So don't doubt and don't fear. So for that, you have to really, really to connect to the infinite love of the Creator, which we call universe, or we call God. And to connect is to act for the love of God. Each time you are good and kind and forgiveness and compassionate to yourself, to others, you are connecting more and more to the Lord, more and more to God. Which I mean, the Lord is absolutely like a bottle full of water of pure God energy. As simple as that. To me, I wish more than anything to be a full butter, a full divine white light, golden white pink water light, full, walking on the water with wings on my back and heart so shiny that it opens the door before you touch them. That's exactly the sacred words for those who know things. You see, it's not to it doesn't mean you have to be faithful like that. You have to understand that at the moment you acknowledge the Lord, you are under protection, you got no idea. And God says, Look for me, search for me, because the moment you catch me, I'm gonna give you everything you wish. I'm gonna surround you by time with diamonds and rubies and sapphires, and you're gonna be full of everything, more than you need. All you need gonna be fulfilled in miraculous ways. So I'm gonna give you a second advice, that every time you eat something wonderful, be thankful. Every time you get the opportunity to have an amazing moment, be thankful, deeply thankful. No, thank you. Really, really go in your heart and be thankful to something that is invisible, like love is invisible. Because if I say I love you, if you don't feel it, what is love? It's an energy. You see? So I'll give you a few keys like that because you deserve it. And you can wake in the night to say, well, God, I didn't know you. I didn't even think about you. And I was far, far from you. And thank you. Help me know you. Thank you. Come into my heart and my life. Lighten me. Guide me. Why don't you try? Life is amazing. Life is love, sharing. Beautiful things like that. Imagine, always good, always good. And when you see something is not going like the way you need it or you want it, it is so easy to say, thank you, God, thank you, Angel, for helping me in this situation. It is so easy to say, try it. I observe and I understood some, God clearly showed me something very important that the same way some important traduction in history disappeared, the same way there are people who block the energy and they are unconscious because they don't know and they still don't understand that all the joy being stolen to human and the joy being stolen in a way that they are forced to work and to be slave. And that absolutely don't know and don't understand what happened to them. I really, really observe that there are double way of attitude in some humans that cheat. That doesn't matter. And there are other people who keep the door open for others. Everything is starting to really, really flowing super, super, super fast. Thank to God, by the way, really, 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 and more than by the way. That means that how to say that? We don't have any, no more place for cheating, bad stuff, and anything like that. Because we still don't understand that with 1 minute of focus, we produce energy. So it's all up to all of us. And we all gonna move. With the reality we create. That's a big effort. So by my side, I really, really decide to stop doing anything more. I'm gonna concentrate on my writings. I observe that we are really at the beginning of new times and the end of another one. A lot of false prophets doing their butter with their tricks. And it's really, really more serious than ever. So I am very happy by my side that I really observed that all needs are fulfilled by God. And how do you say? You have to understand that finally, if to be millionaire is a full-time job, to be a happy man is a full-time job. And God also showed me something very interesting yesterday, because there is that amazing book, which is The City of Joy, which it's a story in India that they observe in the middle of an enormous poverty that the real absolute truth is raising. So there is a balance to get at that moment, because cash is super cool and super practical. But the wise say that when you fulfill one desire, you're gonna get 10 more. And it climbs that way. When you got no really desire, and when you just focus on your needs, they're gonna come, all you need gonna come to you, you don't even know how. So there is a secret in the middle of that, which is if you are really, really true, and if you are really, really God lover, God knows you more than others, and be sure God can send you all your needs fulfilled, more than beyond dreams going to make manifest on the physical plans. All the wishes. So it's always understanding that all human dreams are God dream for any of us. So at the moment you got dreams, you don't have to fight running after your dreams. You have to catch the absolute truth, trust that you're living in your dream. That's very strange to understand. To someone who starts. All I can tell you that is very important, that I've been listening to Jesus Christ's message and I fell in love with Jesus. I was born in love with Jesus Christ. I've been listening to Buddha message and I was totally blossom like a flower, lotus flower. And I've been listening to Muhammad message and I was absolutely amazed. And as I observed deeply those messages were sacred, including Moses' message, I observe one thing. It's absolutely exactly the same true loving unconditional love, joy, harmony that grows when we plant seeds. I also observe that there is one sacred law that's still now, even including me, we didn't observe, we didn't start to love each other. So actually, there are people who start, who try to fight, to feel their darkness and their ignorance. And among them, there are people who get big responsibilities. So we are like baby ladybirds, but we got the same power, even if we don't put our names on the news, numerical news, or TV news yet. We have to understand that what we do and what we focus on is really vibrating a huge over or possibility to understand is really manifesting a huge reality. It seems so big and so wonderful. That's exactly the proof of God's love for us. God is nothing else but everything and anything at the same time. it is really said in some text, Jewish, by the way, they say God made the planets in 6 days and said to his kids, humans, now you get your part to play. There is a link, sacred link, with free will. So I don't know what the trick is. I know, and I really see, you know, I made a pause that heaven told me that the time was coming, and then I was upset about that. I had to come to him, and thank God I came. And also, I asked him without a word to anchor me, because I was starting to fly so high. I mean, really, really above and beyond the six dimension, seven dimension, maybe eight dimension. We observe maybe the few we know. Probably a few masters, really few masters, like two or three masters. Over people who say they are masters, they are clown. There are people who realize themselves. That's a big difference. There are a lot of people, they talk, and they try to share some things they think they know, but knowledge is moving fast light. Because knowledge is made of humility, discipline, pure love, pure service, and really enormous compassion, really for sure. So really, that's absolutely amazing. There is something very important also. That is that there is only one thing that will never change. And that thing is God unconditional love for us. I've been, I can say suffering, because I observed that I was really loving suffering, and then they didn't understood that, and my ego, like mental, told me, you love suffering, and I was like, no, I don't. I say, yes, you love it, because you always put your mind on what you don't like, and somebody said that to you, and somebody did that to you, and who cares? Because you love that somebody who say that so much, so there you go. And you love that's over, that did that to you, and you love that woman so much, who care? But you love more Gaia, and you love more Jesus, and you love more God, and you love more writing, and you love more painting, and you love more singing, and you love more doing music. Because if I tell you, if I got a guitar, you got no idea what I can do. Even me, I am. So we spend our time to complain on what we dislike. We are not grateful. And there is, I'm going to give you a trick, and I use it. At the second you get something, really makes you. When really, at the moment you get something that makes you feeling joyful and happy, that's the perfect moment to say free time. Thank you, God. I'm so grateful. Thank you. You make me so happy. I go crazy. So happy I am. Thank you, God, so much. And my friend Circo, the Santa, super beautiful woman I had in my life, luckily. I am so blessed. I got no idea, really. And I say thank you, God, and I apologize because I've been really complaining so much. And I didn't realize I was so happy. And I am so happy. But I put so much time complaining that years and years go by. And it seems I get younger and younger. I really feeling like I'm doing a thing, actually. I do a stuff. That's so big. There's something happening so huge and so enormous. That's really right here, right now. I can feel that. I was doing bad things, eating anything, and now my body say, it's no more time to eat a lot, doesn't eat any good things, or it's no more time to sleep too much, or things like that. I think like the mountain moved. If you really observe yourself, you're gonna really, really go deep in yourself. You're gonna understand that you built in your mind, like I did, many false ideas. And many unloving thoughts. About the self, about others and things, which are completely wrong. Doesn't exist. And I really wonder why we are carrying that, how do you say, rubbish bag with us all the time. And I really want to talk to the world and say, we need to put down that, put the rubbish box, that rubbish bag. What are we doing? We've been fighting two times. Why do we talk about it again? So what are we doing exactly? Because we are alive now, but soon we're gonna bury too. So I really observe that we are all completely crazy. So by my side I prefer to be crazy like Copernic than to be crazy like an idiot and an ignorant. You see what I mean? And that you get no idea what I've been across over there, because I had to go across 1,000 people to get alive back, awakening, free. That forced me to go deep in me and take away that fucking rubbish. Because I don't care what other things. I know you can't imagine how much I feel the energy. And you can't imagine what is love. Because love can't be touched. Love can't be touched. Love can only be felt. And so because I wrote that on the international talk, journalists, ooh, blah blah, crazy things with a lot of their intention to lead on the wrong way, people to go on the wrong feeling, to put them on the fighting way of living. And then I was like, whew, to read so much insult and negativity and bad stuff, and you got no idea. I tell you, there is no more place for horrible words like fuck, bitch, hustle and everything. I tell you, unfuck yourself. It's time for all of us to take away from our mouth all that vulgarity, insult and bad stuff, because every time we do that, we lock ourselves in a fucking shit. We can't be happy by that. I'll let you listen to that, really. Religions were created to help people awake, to help people acknowledge that there is a force, magnetic, loving force above, and there is a way to be happy. I tell you that religions are cultural way of living. For Asiatic people, cultural way of living, for Arabic people, cultural way of living. And again, to think bad stuff about religious is the way to be slaved by governors who want to take away faith. They stole, they use the best part of the man, which is his religion. They use it against each to destroy each of us. That's a very dangerous game to play with that. Sacred text and religious are precious and sacred because you ain't gonna go to God nowhere if you don't study the text. Until you don't study the text, you're losing your time. And you can see that all those talkers, they all talk about sacred sentence, sacred things was written. And we get to listen carefully to that. By my side, I'll tell you, and I told you already, I am so super happy for 10 years ago, a scientist start to really, really prove that what Jesus is the absolute truth. And today, miraculously, I observed that the most seen video I saw since I go on YouTube is talking about God's proof. And there is 1.5 million people who saw it. Like, I don't know when it was posted, I have to see that. And it's so the people who lead the world and thing, it's not about the people who lead the world, it's about, how do you say, a mistake. And it's about a mistake that was keeping going on, going on and going on and going on for years and centuries with the same mistake. Because I tell you, at the moment you study all of them, you're gonna fall in love with God at the moment you do the effort. So that's exactly that point, that there are people who do efforts and we build themselves with. There is one advice that been given to human, study, learn, do it by yourself. I really, really gonna tell you something really serious and really, really sad, that people that doing things to, how do you say, oh la la, there is like an industry of games, industry of TV, industry of pornography, all that stuff really, really is very alive. Those who fail in it, if you don't spend time with God, you're gonna fall and fall and fall and fall. At the moment, you can't no more, you want to die. And I observe that all around. There are so many people, including me, because I've been putting my nose with their energy, and it makes you really, really want to die. You really, really got no hope, nothing. Because the human been designed to uplift to paradise. There is no way to paradise down. You see that? And the first step to paradise and the first step to joy is to study what Buddha say, what Jesus say, what Muhammad say, what Moses say. Because still you are not curious to wonder what you are doing here. And if you follow people who doesn't know anything, you ain't gonna know nothing about your life. And one day it's gonna be over. And that's very difficult now because industry and numerical sending false information. And they put your brain to be distant. If your brain is not in your heart, linked to God, you ain't gonna go nowhere, and your needs ain't gonna be fulfilled. Even if you become a millionaire, the cash gonna disappear like in a day. And there are many millionaires who suicide. Tell you that. The ideas makers, imagination, builders. And they stay million. They don't need to fight or to be sad. They can keep the stuff going on because it is good. Otherwise, at the moment, if you don't stop to being silly and idiots and mad, playing with devil, you're gonna fall like a shit moment. Everybody gonna go away. And that's the worst thing that can happen to anyone. Terrible. Is so really, really, really very, you have to find your star, you have to find your light, you have to find your, at the moment you get, you find your inner way to God and say, oh, you need a t-shirt, so you need socks, shoes, you need food, and here it is. You don't have anything to do, nothing. And of course Jesus is inside, God is inside, but religions, they include sacred words. You have to read two times. Because you get clearly to understand that if you had no religion, you would ever, never, never, never heard about God. So you would be like searching before Copernic discover anything. Yeah, you have to understand that if those gospel weren't right, how would you know? Do you imagine that 2 centuries ago, somebody can come to you and say, hey, there is a man who came and he has a message for you, that there is a way for happiness? How would you know? How would you know that? Have you ever read the Quran? Go and put your nose on that. If you can feel God inside, is because there are a lot of light workers, we can say like that, that are doing something very powerful for the energy all over humanity. Otherwise, we are prehistorical people. You have to understand there is an all sudden evolution in humanity, and that evolution is totally linked to that moment where we tell you that there is a star shining in the universe, a special one, to remember all of us that there is a way. You can put your head away and lie to yourself, but there is no lie to her heart that is linked to the unconditional love, the ocean of pure compassion. And there is a way to understand that you are face to face to God, and you are face to face to God when you are in terrorist and you put your energy on and on and on and on and on, because it takes like 20 years to awake spiritually, 20 years permanent full job. It's about like 14 years, 20 years to really, really start to make the seeds grow. But you ain't gonna feel anything except be amazed about the beauty of Earth, which is, how can I say that? If all the people who've been working before to put us here now didn't give so much love before, we would be nothing. Because the love you got in your heart is rare and precious. Doing his stuff and putting so much love in what he is every day, there is no example of pure love anywhere if you don't exist. You understand? So let the seeds and the flower grows. Because me, I tell you, my personal experiments, I really wonder what I'm going to do. How? God knows better than I. I let him do, really. I observe things there so much hard way of being, hate so much. And then people that cry because after they spend a weekend, go inside of them, see the way they bury themselves. They cry all of a sudden, awakening. But without religion, there is no awakening. There are a lot of people doing tricks, and that it doesn't work. Tricks doesn't work. Never. It's an illusion. There is only a reality. All that is invisible, and all that is invisible, it is God's love. As the angels are invisible for a lot of people, luckily I can see them when I'm very good, and when I pray or focus 5 minutes on God, they come instantly. And they used religion to destroy people's love among themselves. So be very, very, very careful about the way you are a tool to that society who went totally wrong and who puts humanity in a big hole of desolation and sadness. You understand? You've been used by that stuff nowhere that want to destroy your happiness, stealing you your inner paradise. You hate. You don't know what you hate, but you hate. And all the time put in the hate. You get no time for love. That's what Santa Teresa said, as you know. And they use us as haters to steal women, gold, jewels, and stuff. Think about that. There is so much. The problem is that really, really listen to what I tell you before. I tell you, if your love, if your absolute kindness doesn't exist, nothing is going to go on. But also, if the way you are conditioned and they use your brain to be a hater and to hate the sacred things, to put you in a trap and use you as a tool to fight against yourself and to fight against others. And you don't realize anything. Your brain was manipulated to hate religion. You are manipulated. And you don't know because you didn't even catch any will of learning. You even didn't catch any will of reading because you were, your innocence been stolen for years and years and years. You didn't realize that. You've been made to hate. You were built to hate. So don't put so much anger when you talk about the very devoted people who serve God, because all the hate you put there is by ignorance. At the moment you got to put your nose on what Mohammed says, exactly reading it. And when you're going to put your nose on exactly what Buddha say, exactly, you're going to be voiceless, because if you really, really spend time with those who spend their life to be messenger of the sublime, at that moment, you're going to link live with your higher self. You ain't gonna search and turn around and crying and anything like that. You're gonna understand exactly what is going on more. That there is a force above, and there are people who work all their life to tattoo the proof of their experiments that proves that there is a force above that we are made of. But without all that, you arrive and you take what you like and you take away what you don't like. And if there is an effort to do, you say, no, I don't want to read, or I don't put my energy to pray because I prefer to take the result of others to make the trick. You ain't going to make any tricks if your soul and your heart is not built with those efforts and that discipline. And that's why and how some people like Buddha exist, because he mastered himself and did efforts days and days and years and years and years so that it can happen. And that's a religion. That's what is religion? It's what unites people in their best part. It's exactly what it means. What unites people with the best of their part together. That is religion. And you don't know what to do, because you don't know how to do and how to build yourself, because you were manipulated for hate. That's terrible punishment that comes from people who stole and kill, and they do that for years and centuries. And I tell you something, I am a messenger. And I know personally two of them. Well, look, I travel in my soul and in my heart, thanks to God, every day. And I've been reading the text and spending time a lot. And it's a beginning and it's not enough. But till the moment you get that love starting to flow in you, that humility starting to grow in you, because you've been putting your time with God instead of putting your time how to make this and this and this and this. You don't know what you love, you don't know what you are, till the moment you understand that you are a seed of love, and that seed of God is created in the universe, in that magical stuff, nowhere, every day, everywhere. This is so subtle and so beautiful. Really, really, really don't ever put any hate judgments anywhere, especially on the back of those who wrote all that love for you can live a happy life. And if those guys who wrote in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth didn't did anything, and the religion, we will be a big shit and a big mess and suffering, you got no idea how deep. So put your anger away. Finally, the moment you understand that God created a bowl of love with water and animals and trees, for we are happy, and he religiously unite us all. You understand that we humans really religiously hate us. And that's exactly that point. We didn't make it. We have to religiously love each other's. In French, if I can tell that in French, and if you could speak French, you understood exactly what I mean when I tell you read all the religious texts, for you understand your own unity and you think by yourself, then you understand that there are people around you that make you think in a wrong way, with so much hate that you are pushed to fight. And that's exactly that point why we got wars, that there are a lot of people who didn't study anything and they didn't understand anything. And with their ignorance, they fight to say that they are right with what they don't know, because they don't know nothing and they didn't make any efforts by themselves. So don't fight. And don't think with others' ignorance minds. Think with your own knowledge. Study. Then you'll be free. You see? Right here, right now, I am on my knees and I kiss the grass and I kiss the earth, that ball of love made to unite us all with an understanding complete of what was made for us, for we can keep on being happy. To love each other with our knowledge and understanding that we are all made of pure beauty, and religion are translation with habits of every part of the world to share the most beautiful thing we got. Religion is absolutely the most beautiful thing ever made on words. There is nothing else. Without religion, there is the cow.
I must tell you, that's really that I was saying to many people, start in America, that people say, American, I like that, or Italian, I like that, or Spanish, I like that. No one is the same. And I don't know where it comes from. It's very bad because it makes, maybe it's media, it makes people criticize each other and things. It's ridiculous. If you know three people who are Chinese or Japanese, I don't know, or French or whatever, none of the three person will be the same. So I think it is really, and we have to be very careful because that trap is so fucking big. And humanity is pushed in that direction to criticize all races and to build them against each other. And I must admit that it is so strong to be very careful, because the moment you observe one or two people you don't like, they're, I don't know, Dutch or French or English, or I don't know, you start to say, oh, English people, they are like that. No, they are not like that. They're super. Spanish people are super. French people are super. Because, by the way, everybody mix with everyone. And it is big stuff, big thing. Make me feel like vomit, by the way. Really, it's really ridiculous. It's really super strange, and I've been talking to that about that with friends of mine
like 6 months ago, and I tell them all, don't ever fall in that big trap. Because at the moment you start to feel you are in this, automatically consider back that it's wrong idea. It's built by people who got interested to destroy others, you see. Everybody's different. It really means that we all got our own experiments. We all got unique parents, and we all got unique brothers and sisters. We belong to family, and we are all very sensitive. Because when the first tooth of a baby come, everybody's happy, it's very nice. And but when someone got a tooth hurt, when somebody fall, break something, it is terrible. It is painful. Everybody, we rush to the doctor, and the family comes in. How does he or she goes now? Is he or she gonna heal? And we are all very upset for healings of the one we love. It also means that, for instance, when there is a fight in the country, we are very sad when the news say there are a lot of people being killed, or being very upset about some country, or the people need more food. You see, your baby needs more support, clear water, clean clothes, healthy house. So we are very sensitive. And as far as I can observe, I realize humanity is amazing, and people are very, very kind. And a lot of people are really dedicate their life for service, and other people are just focusing on great gentleness. I got friends like that who are amazingly gentle and generous, a lot of them. They appear miraculously. As I start to really think that the world is so beautiful and people are wonderful, step by step, a lot of wonderful people appear in my life. So I've been falling in love with someone wonderful for just to say a few about it, coming from Lebanon. That I didn't know that country at all, except that I was very deeply touched by what was going on in that country during the 80s. And I decided to go to see in Beirut how is it. And I've been to paradise over there. The kindness of the people is just stunning. Everybody share, and everybody care. That is a wonderful way of living. To be supporting each other, since they are example people. And I fell in love really with that country. So we have really to be center, and not to fall in the trap of the journalist, or I don't know what is that. Kind of idea that appear, probably coming from politicians, that because we have the politician we got, so they do what they can, and sometimes they can't do anything, and they want to keep their place, you know, and there are a lot of things to solve. So we start to say, yes, American politicians, they are not so easy. So a lot of people start to get mad about America. because the politicians are rude. But let me tell you, go to America and you're gonna see the kindness of American people. And that's why I really invite everybody who offered me the great honor to listen to me till now. And I thank you so deeply in the heart, all of you. I just want to tell you, don't ever fall in that trap to say, well, American people are like that, or Italian people are like that. Because I swear to you, Hans, my babies of the world, if you know, for instance, I don't know, three Japanese people, or three Chinese people, or three Lebanese people, or three French people, or three, I don't know, Dutch people, war is over. We have to forgive and to let go all that bad stuff from the past. We have to understand new kids came. We have to understand that kids help their parents grow. We change, we move. Everybody knows that every day we understand something bigger, and it takes time to put it in practice. So really, check by yourself. Just go step by step to know each of us, all of us. Start to go on, discover the beauty of humanity, discover the beauty of everyone, because everybody got something to learn and to share with others. We are little drop in a big ocean. Me, I love to say that I am nothing. I do few things, pretty useless, but sometimes it may help someone. And that's a big joy to me. If one or two or three or 100 people or 1,000 people are deeply touched by my will of caring, sharing, loving. Of course I do mistake. But if there is a big awake, or if there is a miracle after prayers, that's amazing to my heart. And it makes me understand step by step how deep the family, the human family, is beautiful. And the most beautiful thing about it is that, yes, in Israel there are trouble, but there are a lot of amazing Jewish people. And I'm going to say thank you, for example, to a friend of mine. His name is André, and he supports me since my dad went to paradise and I got no more family, no more parents. And he come often and say, I got a box of chocolate for you. And he's so kind. And he got a lot of work and a big family to master, to manage. And he take time for me because he supports me and he touched my heart deeply. So today he came to visit me and say, are you okay? I say, okay, I got something for you. And he supports me in many, 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 many ways. And for instance, that man is his family is from Morocco and he is Jewish. So you can see that Arabian people and Jewish people can mix very well together, because a lot of Jewish are Arabian. So there is really no reason to fight. There is really no reason to listen to the media guided by the politician, because the interest of the politician is to steal gas, is to steal oil and a lot of things. So don't listen to them. Keep on doing your everyday nice work and little kindness and support to each of us, to your neighbors, because I know perfectly that in the street of Paris, Arabians are very well loved and very welcome. And I apologize to them, by the way, because I used to live very often in France, And we love Islamic people a lot, a lot. So the false fight that be building for stealing things to other countries is not good to follow. It is not a reason to let the media lead your heart and your mind. And I can tell you, I'm not Jewish. I don't have to say it, but I say it. And I get many Jewish friends, and I get many Christian friends, and I get many Buddhist friends, and I got also Druze friends. I got friends everywhere from every religion, and all the races of the world are stunning beauty. There are diamonds in the skies, diamonds in the stars. We are stars in the sky. Because let's do that exercise together. We're gonna just imagine that we're a big family. And take a big, big breathing, very deeply breathe, and let go all that anger of the past, those fights, those wars that politician leads the people of the world to fall in. And they invite people to choose a camp. There is no camp. Humanity is a family. There is no reason to let a child cry in the middle of the war, or a daddy looking for his wife or his kids in the middle of the guns fightings. We have to say stop. And if someone is suffering or looking for food, please open your heart, open your bag, and give a sandwich to the one who is on your roads and is suffering from starving, or is suffering because his country is in war. Open your heart and open your house, because I tell you, if someone is in suffering and you got cash to pay his bill and he cannot, a day or another, if you do that, a day or another, God gonna send you someone to pay your bills. That's the power of God. He talks into our hearts, and those who listen act to support each other, their neighbors. And by the way, that's exactly what happened to me. I've been supporting someone who was dying sad and stole by the politicians that he helped, and they trick him. And by luck, I could support him. And I was very honored to do that. And he was sad, and he was starving. And at the moment, I had more cash, so I could support that man I love so much. And he supports me when I had to rent the house, and he invited me in his house and offered me a wonderful Christmas. So, all my babies of the world, Merry Christmas. And don't ever forget that when a baby born in your neighbor family, it is your child too. It is your cousin. And when you take a little time to smile and to hug the others, God gonna take a lot of time to smile at you. And he smile at me, and I smile at you, all of you.
Viens petite fille dans mon comex, tu viens faire le but, faire des whip, des whiz, des pow, chiba, pow, pow, whiz.